to the thing. It wouldn't even record.
This guy wasn't even recording.
All right, guys. It's the evening of October the 23rd. I'm packing all my stuff up right now. I'm getting ready to get on the road. I'm going to head up to Ohio. I'm pulling a solo trip this trip. I ain't got nobody to go with me, so I'm going to go up there and hunt the private farm that I have up there. I've had some pretty good deer showing up on camera, and I think I got a good chance if I go up there and see one in daylight. So it's October the 24th, and the weather's looking good, and then big bucks should be starting to cruise during daylight, starting to check stuff out. So I'll catch you on a tree when I get up there, so stay tuned. So I kind of just wanted to show everybody how I set up in the JX3. As y'all can tell from the video this morning, that buck was in front of me. But I'm using this tree. Kind of see it here. Okay, I'm using this tree. I'm behind it. And this is just like with any other saddle. I'm set up, you know, to shoot in front of me. So that way all I got to do is swing around the tree to shoot to that angle. And that worked perfect this morning. That buck didn't know I was anywhere in this world. And he was just working a little licking branch slash rug down there. And I kind of just slowly got around the tree, grabbed my bow. And then y'all got to see the video of that. But yeah, I just kind of want to take a moment and show y'all the JX3. I know a lot of people know about them, but I haven't really seen them or how they work. But I mean, I can lay back in it like this. If you want to stand, you can stand up just like you would with a regular saddle. I'll take my hands, lay them over, and just kind of rest. But yeah, that's kind of how the JX3 works, and it's a real nice feature to have. But just like any saddle, it's a little bit different shooting with a bow out of one, so definitely have to practice, and I probably even need to practice more myself. But it was just bad luck this morning, like y'all seen. Well, y'all didn't actually get to see what happened, but that buck, after he come in dead at me, was only about 10 yards, and I drew back, and where he was so close, I was shooting down on him, so I knew I had to really tuck it right to the right of the spine, because I was worried if he went any further, he would be in too much brush. And so when I shot, the deer actually flinched and moved his head up, and when he did that, I dead-centered his main beam, and the arrow just stuck straight into his beam. So, and it looked like it would have been a perfect shot, but that's just how luck goes. But, and if you're wondering why I didn't shoot the deer when he was broadside, it was really dark, and even though you can't tell in the video, because the video will look like it's more light out than what it was, I just couldn't really tell if he was a shooter or not. And even now that I look back at it, I still don't know exactly that I'm happy or sad that I didn't kill him. So, oh well. Guys, I'm not going to be able to video if this bug comes in, because he's behind me and I have my camera.